Former Chief UN Weapons Inspector David Kaye joins me now via Skype. He's in the U.S. state of Delaware. David Kaye, thanks for being with us. So is the key word here declared equipment has been destroyed? Because how do we know that Syria is declaring everything it has at this stage in a war zone?
We simply don't know, but it is important that on the declared facilities, particularly the production site, I think everyone is reasonably confident that they knew where the production sites were. The second is the filling and mixing equipment. This is easier to hide, harder to be sure you know about everything, but you certainly have eliminated the major portion of anything they would have in this area. So it is an important milestone, but you're right to underline declared.
Right, and the weapons placed under seal, what does that mean exactly? Does that mean they're neutralized for good, or can they be utilized once again?
No, they're not neutralized for good, and this is something that there is ambiguity in how it's being reported. Look, a seal can be as little as a paper seal. It can be wax and wire, a metal seal. I've personally used all kinds of seals, but the one thing I know about seals is they can be broken. What it does is it guarantees you that if it's broken, you will know it. Now, there are no inspectors left in Syria now. They all withdrew after completing the destruction of the production, mixing, and filling facilities. So you wouldn't know immediately, and you wouldn't know unless you have someone on the ground to know who did it. And that's important in the context of a civil war. I quite frankly am uneasy that they have left entirely without the opportunity to observe whether, in fact, the seals are in place continuously.
And are you surprised at how quickly this is all going? I remember before the inspectors even made it to Syria, so many experts were saying, hang on, this is going to take years. And in a war zone situation, even longer than that. And this is all happening in a few weeks.
Well, it's happening at the easiest part, but I think you have to give the Syrian government their due. I think more importantly, the Russians for maintaining pressure on the Syrians. The production facilities, mixing and so forth, is the easiest to destroy. You do it with a hammer, you do it with a grinder, you do it with a plasma torch. You can even do it with a tank by running over some of the equipment. I think all of these were used here. The much more difficult thing is, A, being sure you have everything, not just what they've declared. And then when you get to the actual weapons, we're talking about 1,000 metric tons of agent and weapons. That's far more difficult and more time consuming. And even the Syrians now in Damascus are telling the press, well, it's going to be very difficult to meet the timelines. I think that's absolutely true. It's going to be difficult in the context of a civil war. And there are many opportunities for a slip right now. The inspectors only went to 23, I think it is, of the 24 facilities that the Syrians had declared. The interesting thing is that before the war, the U.S. was reporting that there were 40 facilities. No one has gone to the other 15 or so that we thought we knew about. But
and of those 23, I was going to say, sorry to jump in, of those 23, two were not accessible to the inspectors as well. So it's really 21. And if there's 40 plus, you're looking possibly at only half the sites.
Well, you are, if in fact, you know, it's perfectly possible, Ella, that the intelligence was wrong. I'm familiar with that. It can be wrong and tends to be wrong on the high side. But you knew, should go to the sites that you thought you knew about, if nothing else, to confirm that nothing is there. In the context of a civil war, though, that's very, very difficult, since many of these sites are in areas controlled by the rebels, and the rebels are various groups, some of whom would like to have their hands on chemical weapons.